In the heart of Australia's silent deserts, where the dust meets a scorching sun and the wind whispers secrets older than time, lies a creature you'll likely never meet, but that's a blessing. It doesn't roar, it doesn't chase, it doesn't need to, because a single drop of its venom is enough to silence life. It is not just venomous, it is the most venomous snake on Earth. Meet the inland taipan, often called the fierce snake or the small-scaled snake. Most people have never seen one, and yet it holds a title that puts every cobra, viper, or rattlesnake to shame. But how did this reclusive snake earn its crown? Why is it so lethal? And why is Australia, the land it calls home, overflowing with so many of the world's most dangerous creatures? The inland taipan is not a snake that seeks attention. In fact, it's remarkably shy and rarely seen by humans in the wild. Living mostly in the dry, remote regions of Queensland and South Australia, it blends perfectly into the cracked clay and grasslands of the Channel Country. Unlike other aggressive snakes, the inland taipan will flee rather than fight. But make no mistake, when threatened or cornered, it can strike with lightning speed, delivering multiple rapid bites in seconds. What makes this snake terrifying is not its size. It's relatively modest, measuring about 6 to 8 feet. It's the chemistry within. A single bite contains enough venom to kill 100 adult humans, or over 250,000 mice. Let that sink in. So, what makes the inland taipan's venom so deadly? Its bite delivers a toxic cocktail that attacks the body on multiple fronts. Neurotoxins that shut down the nervous system, myotoxins that dissolve muscles, and coagulants that cause blood to clot into deadly clumps. In short, the venom is designed to paralyze, destroy, and overwhelm every system of the body in a matter of minutes. But here's the most mind-blowing part. Despite being the deadliest snake on Earth by venom potency, there are virtually no recorded deaths from inland taipan bites. Why? Because the snake is so reclusive, and because people who work near them, like herpetologists or reptile handlers, are always cautious and well-equipped with antivenom. To understand how the inland taipan came to exist, we need to understand its environment. Australia is not just a continent, it's a crucible. Isolated for over 40 million years, its ecosystem evolved in complete uniqueness, becoming a home to some of the world's most dangerous animals. Here, you'll find the saltwater crocodile, the most powerful reptile alive, the box jellyfish with venom so excruciating it can stop the heart in minutes, the blue-ringed octopus, small enough to sit on your palm, yet capable of killing you with a bite that feels like nothing more than a pinch. There's the funnel-webbed spider, the stonefish, and the cone snail, which can shoot a venomous harpoon. Even land animals like dingoes and boxing-strong kangaroos add to the harsh survival landscape. So why does Australia breed such lethal creatures? The answer lies in natural selection and isolation. Predators and prey co-evolved in the land with limited competition, extreme climates, and no major mammalian carnivores. This forced many species to develop chemical warfare as their primary means of defense and offense. And the inland taipan? It's Australia's ultimate product. Unlike cobras or vipers that evolved in jungle or forest ecosystems, the inland taipan evolved in arid deserts where hunting had to be quick, efficient, and silent. Prey like native rats and small mammals are fast, and if the snake failed to kill quickly, it risked starvation or injury. That's why its venom became a surgical tool, not just to kill, but to do it instantly. Its venom composition is so advanced that it evolved to minimize struggle. One bite, one kill. That efficiency not only secures food faster, but also protects the snake from being attacked in return. Interestingly, its close cousin, the coastal taipan, is aggressive and often near human dwellings, but its venom is slightly less potent. The inland Taipan, hidden in its dry inland realm, needed even more biological precision, and it got it through millions of years of slow, quiet evolution. You might ask, what about king cobras or black mambas? Aren't they more dangerous? In terms of human interaction, yes, they're responsible for more deaths. But in terms of venom potency per milligram, nothing surpasses the inland Taipan. It's LD50, the lethal dose required to kill 50% of test subjects, is the lowest recorded in any snake. That means it takes the least amount of venom to do the most damage. Its fangs are long, its venom glands are efficient, and its strike is one of the fastest in the snake world. But what truly crowns the inland Taipan is its perfect balance. Lethal without being reckless, deadly without being aggressive, and precise like nature's own assassin. The inland Taipan teaches us something strange about danger. It doesn't always come with warning signs. Sometimes the most powerful creatures don't scream or roar. They slither silently through the dust, unseen, unknown. And in that quiet lie absolute power. It reigns not because of its body count, but because of what it could do, if it wanted to. And that, perhaps, is the most terrifying thing of all. Australia may be the arena of deadly beasts, but the inland Taipan stands at the top of that hierarchy, not with brute strength, but with elegance, precision, and biochemical genius. If you've made it this far, you've just come face to face with the most venomous snake on Earth, without the risk. What do you think? Should this silent serpent be feared or admired? Let me know in the comments. And if you love exploring nature's deadliest mysteries, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell. Stay wild, stay curious, and I'll see you in the next one.